Hello, Klaus here, and welcome to another video. So, Davinci Resolve is now out in the beta, and I did do some videos about the face refinement tool, but it has been optimized a little bit in the new version. And I did do a tutorial. I thought it would be just beneficial if I did a new tutorial on how it works. So, without further ado, let's go to the editing suite. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and we are having a look at the face refinement tool, which has a couple of new things, or it has been improved since the last version. We are now in the beta version 4 of DaVinci Resolve 16. So it has improved since it was introduced in version 15, I think. So first off, let's find it. We'll just go up here and search for it. And then we'll just drag it here on the second node I have here. And first off, as we need to do is we need to do a analyzing of this clip. So we'll just analyze my face pretty darn quick, hopefully. And so one of the problems there were in the version in version 15 was that sometimes there would be some strange artifacts when you did too much, and kind of understand that, of course, but and it seems like those are gone now. So at least we'll find out. It was mostly visible when you did do a render, and this is a pretty nice tool, but this tool will work the best for footage shot similar to like this, like a talking head or something. It's not going to give you a very good result if it's shot from the side, for instance, or something like that. So here we are done with the analyzing, and then we can of course turn off the overlays. It looks pretty cool when you are analyzing to have them on. So okay, so let's just go here to the skin mask here we have here. This is not so important because again, one of the new things is on the texture, the beauty plugin has actually been added in here. It's a separate plugin still in DaVinci Resolve, but now it's inside of the face refinement tool as well. And what the beauty plugin is basically, either we can smooth things out or we can do some advanced beauty stuff. Let's just take the automatic one. So if we in the amount, for instance, go towards negative, as you will see on my skin, it becomes all the details will be very visible and all my wrinkles will be even more visible. And if we go the other way, we can then smoothen out the skin to an extent where it gets pretty much too much. Okay, and then of course we could scale the size of that as well. I'm just going to reset that. Or you can also do a animation. For instance, we could quickly do a animation like this, going from extremely old skinned to bothery smooth. So here we have that over time being younger by the second. Anyway, that is just a little thing you can do. Of course, now also one of the things which are new in DaVinci Resolve 16 is the ability to keyframe even more things. So, and I think this was one of those. So of course, we also have the color grading, and the color grading, we can change the contrast, and everything we are doing is focused on the face. So we could either make it look better or worse, depending on what we do. Again, it's nice to be able just to boost some colors, not too much. And then you can change the tint if your skin tones aren't good enough. Okay, and then of course, if you have some shine, you can also remove that. As you see, I have some over at the right side here because my light was coming from there, and I can remove that a bit so it'll look a little bit better. Okay, and then of course we have the eye retouching, which I like. I think that is a very good one. So you can go and sharpen the eyes, as you see. If we toggle it off, maybe we'll just toggle the effect off. You can see how much that actually are doing. So here I am sharpening the eyes. I can brighten the eyes. And of course that can be used to an extent where it gets too much, like everything else in life. So it should be used pretty subtle, I think, and not too much. Then you also have a eye light. So you can kind of add this eye light here. And you can actually just do this with the using masks, of course, just using doing a circle shape around the eye and then just boost up the gain. But you can do it in here as well. And then, of course, we have the eye bag removal, where we can remove your eye bags if you are getting into the older age thing. Well, again, it can be very much too much. And then, of course, we have some lip retouching. And we can, of course, with the lip retouching, change the hue if we were going for, and also the saturation. And then we can smoothen the upper lip as well. Wow, that's beautiful. So and also we have some blush retouching, so we can do a bit of makeup here. So if we were to fix makeup in post, we could do it. And also we have some forehead reduction we can do. And let's do a little bit of that and do some saturation, and then we can smooth out the skin. So here we are already looking much better. And also we can do some with the cheek reduction as well. Let's go in here and let's see what we can do. Again, we can do some, we can hue or saturate it. So let's hue it a bit and give it a bit of saturation. And then also we can do some chin retouching here. Again, a little, let's say a little less here, something like that. Something like that looks good. And then of course we could just blend all this together. So we can take the original clip and we can blend it together with the normal one here. I think let's do a little with the eyes here as well. Okay, we'll just brighten up the eyes a bit here. So that is a super fast look at the face refinement tool in DaVinci Resolve. It is only available in the studio version, but by now, with all the Blackmagic Pocket 4K cameras being sold, most people can get access to DaVinci Resolve Studio. And I would recommend you to go on to the studio version, skip Premiere or whatever editing platform you're going, because DaVinci Resolve is crushing it right now with constantly new updates. Anyway, I do hope you found this super fast video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, and share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.